Hello, greetings, my friends. This is Gilles Mancillon. I wanted to wish you a wonderful day, for there is a great deal of celebrations that are coming, and there is this great portal, this portal on the 26th, this Wesak full moon, which is also a super moon, and it's also an eclipse of the moon, and it will be followed on June 10th by a solar eclipse. It is a very powerful cosmic elevator. It is something that is very unprecedented. It's a diamond gate, a diamond star gate, and it will communicate the platinum ray, and this will assist in the creation of a telepathic matrix, a light matrix around the planet, where we're going to be able to communicate a lot more with our thoughts. It's going to be an upgrade in our feeling senses. For the moons needs to be cleansed of all negative electromagnetic and inorganic frequency. The moon was for those who know, it was not a natural satellite of the Earth. It was the guardian of the prison for a long time. But she's been adopted by the Earth, and she's been cleansed and purified. And the moon is the revelator of the divine feminine. So all women mostly needs to reintegrate the purity of the divine feminine, as men as well, this divine love frequency. And so this will be a very, very powerful cleansing process. Once we stay above the frequency of the distorted energies that can be still broadcasted, we will be completely impermeable to the negative. And there is a divinity that will supervise the process of disintegration of this galactic platinum ray. Is the goddess Aurora. For a chance Wednesday to meet this beautiful Aurora, or Merced Aurora with the pink finger, the beautiful Aurora, and she showed me the magic of a way to bring from the night into the light, from the darkness into the light, from the night into day, and she brings that and bring the cosmic light. So she will be assisting us with that, for we need to clear all the lower, the distorted, the inorganic, the electromagnetic distortions, all of that, and so just rest well. Just the more we are relaxed, the more we are take naps, the more you take care of your sense of peace and well-being, the more you will be able to utilize this cosmic elevator, these waves of light that will be coming. There will be a feeling of liberty, freedom, and sovereignty, a sense of empowerment that will be coming, because once we establish ourselves in the higher frequency, mental, emotional, dimensional frequency, we can turn on and off the matrix. We can still see it, but as a play, we don't have to participate. We'll continue to participate in this physical world, but we'll know we can turn it on and off. We won't be absorbed by it. And so it's going to be quite nice. Also, it's important to let go of all social or familial obligations, things that your social circle or your family feel. You have those obligations. No longer. And when you say no, you don't have to justify why you say no. Just say no. That's all. Don't go into expensive explanation why you justify yourself, why you say no. Just say no, and that's it. And follow on what is really, what you feel true, what you feel good. What makes you feel good, not to be drained into the old cycles. Well, I'm going to pull a few cards. If you want a private session, you can send me an email. I usually use the tarot on through Skype to address the questions, to bring back to the forward of consciousness like this, those things that needs to be, that are already there, but needs to be understood to be more conscious in our choices. I also thank you for liking, for sharing, for commenting. I appreciate your comment, for subscribing if it's not done, and for your donations. Very kind. But so much is going on, and also we're already in the preparation for really something completely to a world, to a free life of celebration and joy. For the past is the request. We're learning to make requests. We ask and we receive. Whenever you call to spirit or you call on to God, they're there. The response becomes more and more present, more obvious. It's like if you don't feel it, it's because something in your mind prevents you from feeling the automatic response of life. Where we are, the situation is healing right now. We are healing. There is those light chambers that are being prepared as well. The light chambers, we go there when we sleep. The light chambers in ships or in the inner earth, that are really here to, it's going to assist us with the final cleansing, with the liberation of all negative sort of patterns and the crystallization of our body. And the future, the outcome will be joy. Joy, So we'll be really enjoy. Right now we're still in hesitation. There is still a part of us, but this portal will really assist us and give us the courage to overstep whatever blockages, and the outcome will be rejoicing. We'll rejoice. We'll find joy. And so it'll be very potent and powerful. And so, because it is good to, if we can, to move in total gratitude for each moment. It's a step-by-step process. We don't want to move from one level to another and miss out on all the level. It's like it's good to like in nature, to feel every step of the way and to be in total gratitude for who you are, for being part of a greater whole, for being present within this earth, for this important transition, for the final ending will be quite surprising. And so, and be in gratitude for progressing just moment by moment, for life is created moment by moment. We're moving from Homo sapien to Homo luminous, to Homo galacticus, to Homo universalis. We're becoming totally different kind of being. And for that, as we let go, we surrender the old, the past. We have to clear the inner chaos. The chaos is actually inner chaos that we need to clear up. But as we clean up the inner chaos, we move above and we see things from a different perspective, a different light, and we have far more power in the influence that we have in the world, in the manifestation transition towards the higher, bringing, elevating the situations. For there is an introspection and a deconstruction inside that is happening. And that is happening on all dimensions. All beings are ascending, for even on the higher planes, they're deconstructing their own reality in order to move to the higher level. So it is part of the process. For you are the light and the darkness and the nothingness. For you are one with the whole, the supreme creator. For God is light, darkness, but is also nothing and everything at the same time. So it's about letting go to a lot of the mental process in order to allow that to integrate. For at the beginning, there was only God and God only. We were all part of God. We were like one with God at the beginning. And then there was this grand experiment of the universe that was created. And so the oneness got separated from oneness. It just moved on to this grand experience. But now there's the call. The Father called all his children back home. And so although the ego may tell you otherwise, all those things, well, some people may not accept all those things I'm talking about, but in the due time, they will come and say, well, maybe that was true. For the ego may tell you otherwise, for your will and the will of God are one. This can always be the divine will, even when it's distorted. It's all wills are part of the will of God, but then we want to align with the will of wisdom, the will of God. For anything that's not part of that is like a distortion. For feeling the constant presence of God, being total surrender, and understand the kingdom of God is within your heart, deep hidden, deep within your heart. My guide showed me, I don't always have access to that, but they showed me this kingdom of God deep within my heart, so beautiful, so amazing. I'm like, there's this great enthusiasm and eagerness in being fully integrated with this connection within the heart. So we don't have to seek it out outside. We need to clear our heart of all the anything that is inferior. And so, I know the guidance is all the time, it's always guided in all ways. And the expression of your highest dream is the vision that God has for you. So focus on what is wanted, focus on your dreams or your goal, and let go to trust that Spirit will find a way to make it happen for you. I'll pull a few more cards. The highest wisdom is nothing is like your home. To feel good in your body, to feel good in your environment. If you're not in the perfect place, know you're going to be moved to somewhere that's going to be far more. Just imagine, visualize, don't compromise your dream. Just ask, continue to ask the universe to see what feels comfortable for you. For God has it all, so he can provide anything for anyone when it's the time, when it's ready. What we need to understand is the never-ending story. It is letting go of the drama that is going on in the lower planes, not to be attached to drama, not to believe the drama is real. What we need to do is breathing, just stand in the breath. The breath is the liberation point. It's where it's all happened. We are breathers. Don't wear, if you wear a mask, just think to breathe once in a while. And the outcome is rest, relaxation. It's the time of the nap. It's about letting go of stress, taking breaks, meditation, all those things. So there's a sort of thought into my head that's talk about a book. It's a book that I thought I should talk about it. It's a book by an author named Tolkien. Tolkien was this book, this story. It's an epic story. It was made famous to the grand public by a series of movie called The Lord of the Ring. But The Lord of the Ring is just a little tiny part of the story before and the story after. But actually, it's not a fantasy that came out of Tolkien's mind. It is a very ancient memory at a time where there was no industrialization, but the world was far more magic. Yet there was already this battle between darkness and light, the power of Sauron is the great demon but at the beginning Sauron wasn't a bad guy. He just became that at the time, for those who know the beginning of the story. But this power is dissolving all this total world dominations, all those powers, although they've been pretty successful at holding this frequency for a time. But it's a bit brutal, this story of Tolkien, but it's a quite interesting vision. And Tolkien, it was Tolkien and Lewis Carroll was like the two authors that addressed the world of magic at that time in England. And so, but I don't know what is, those memories came back of those old time in the Middle Earth. For there's going to be a lot, the restoration of the natural kingdom and the elementals and the elves and all that. They will return into the consciousness of humanity. But we're going to be free from all those dark opposition very soon. For the divine plan is infinitely complex, and there is no, we don't know what it is, yet it's familiar, we're getting glimpse of it. Only God knows God. It is known on paradise, only the eternal Son and the infinite Spirit knows the universal Father in its totality. So it's about accepting that there will always be mystery to be unfolded. But the higher we rise in frequency, in consciousness, the more we can understand what this plan of God for us. We may not understand it on a universal level, but it's right now there is this call to return. For disclosure will happen. There are many much life that is going on outside of the planet, and there may be more and more UFOs coming. Some UFOs may come from the secret programs of the Earth, other programming from other maybe from negative beings like drones or whatever. And others maybe from the Federation. So it's not because there is a UFO that you want to walk in. You want to know what's going on before you walk into those things, even if they come, if they show up. But before the first contact is actually happening with the forces of light, there has to be a disclosure. The knowledge for humanity to know this is really happening, it is real. And disclosure, all the dark negative extraterrestrials, such as the Greys, the Anunnakis, the Draconians, there are positive Greys, positive Anunnakis, and positive Draconians as well. But the main negative forces are those reptilian forces and their clones are very much they made secret agreement, and disclosure will kind of cut short their programs. People will not want to be abused by those beings. So it's like it's all about this disclosure is very important to put an end to many of those negative programs for once. Then, because of free will, once we know, we're unified around the frequency of and the same thing before the arrest and the trials of all the negative humans that are controlling the world can actually happen. For it is already happening, but they're replaced by clones right now because there is not enough. The attendance is not ready. People that from the light that comes in to take over the control and the interim governments that can manage the affairs of the world. So for now, it's a very discrete process. But all of that may be happening. June may be a very shifting time. A lot of revelations, and this week is very intense. A very shifting time in relationship to the collective consciousness. There will be a lot of awakening as a result of this full moon eclipse. So I just once thought I come and wish you a good day. For there is a great deal of celebration here on my side. Here in Brussels, we have the four seasons every day. We have cold, we have warm, we have rain, we have sunshine. It's like every day. It's like the time is very, very changing and shifting. And so, but it is we're getting ready for departure for something completely new. It is coming. Well, I'm going to sing a song that's a reminder of that grace appears at the times I first believe. Believe and it shall happen. And believe in God. Know that you are God. You are all that is. And you are an extension of source and nothing else. Don't let your ego interfere with this knowledge. And just apply that in every possible way in your life. It goes like this. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. When we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. What's a beautiful time, reintegrating this moon frequency, the solar logos, become that solar logos, activate the sun within, to be in gratitude, to stay in gratitude and relax, do all those things, let go of so-called responsibility, to please others, to take care of yourself, to be in receptive mode for the times that are coming, and follow your guidance, whatever your guidance call you to do. And there will be great celebration. The card of the day is the Three of Raphael. It's the three mermaids, but it's the three graces. That is very the card of intimacy and celebration and festivity. It says, you have so many reasons to party. A community of friends, good news in relationship to a relation of children. Oh, it's very much a card of celebration, of sharing, so that there will be, prepare yourself for great times to come. And if I was going to leave you with any advice, would be that just be already in the joys, in rejoicing, and let go of the doubts about that. And I thank you very much. I wish you a wonderful day, and I'll talk to you later. Namaste.